Let's offer our respects to Srila Prabhupada. We see in the previous class, which was
yoga ladder.
Yes, we saw the yoga ladder. Yes, very nice. So what did we see in the yoga ladder? Saket is feeling sleepy, huh? Okay, which chapter of the Gita did we finish?
Chapter 6.
We finished chapter 6. So with that, we finished the first section of the Bhagavad Gita. So what was Arjuna's last question we saw in chapter 6? What was Arjuna's last question to Krishna? Okay, so let me share my screen. Kali Yuga. So Krishna's last question to Arjuna, which we saw, was Arjuna asking him, what is the destination of an unsuccessful transcendentalist? What if somebody has taken through the spiritual process, but for some reason has not attained the goal? So what is the destination of such people? And then Krishna, he answers this saying that, if one falls after a short practice of yoga, then he takes birth in either a rich aristocratic family or in the family of righteous people. Why? Because both these conditions are favorable for him to develop his Krishna consciousness. And if he falls down after a long practice of yoga, then he takes birth in the family of a transcendentalist, which means an acharya or a spiritual master. So there it's even more favorable. The situation is even more favorable for him to complete or finish off the pending work from his previous lifetime. So this was Arjuna's last question to Krishna in chapter 6. Now after Krishna answers this question, then in the final verse, he lays the foundation for Bhakti Yoga, where Krishna is saying, of all the yogis, he who always abides in me with great faith, Shraddhavan, he says, with great faith, worshipping me in transcendental loving service, is most intimately united with me in yoga. So of all the yogis, of all these processes that Krishna has discussed so far, no, he saw Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Ashtanga Yoga, he's saying of all these yogis, the one who practices Bhakti Yoga is the highest. So So Krishna is saying, Mat Gate Nantar Atmana. Always think of me from within. So now in chapter 7, Krishna is going to discuss how we have to think of Krishna. How to do it. That question he is going to answer in chapter number 7. Okay, one second. Okay, then Krishna is going to also say, Krishna says Shraddhavan with faith, right? We have to render the loving service to him in full faith. So for us to place the faith in one person, we need to have information about that person. If somebody enters a room and says, you place your faith in me, I will solve your problems or I will do something for you, then obviously we want to know who that person is. We just cannot place our faith on somebody just like that, right? Without any information about that person. So we need to know more about that person. Therefore, now Krishna, beginning from chapter 7, he begins to talk more and more about himself. In fact, in this middle section, which we are going to see, Krishna opens up his heart and he reveals a lot about himself. And many of these things may feel, we have never heard of it before. So it may be a little difficult for us to understand this. But we have to always remember that this middle section where Krishna is opening up his heart, we are hearing from Krishna. Krishna is speaking here. It's not that ISKCON people say this or somebody else is saying this or Prabhupada is saying this. Of course, Prabhupada is saying, but he is only repeating what Krishna has spoken. So we are hearing from Krishna. That we have to always remember. Because in this section, Krishna is going to reveal a lot more about himself. And why does he say so much about himself? So that we have information about the person on whom we have to place our faith. And how to think of that person that Krishna is going to reveal in these middle chapters. So we have seen the format how Krishna, Arjuna asks questions and Arjuna answers. And here Arjuna asks this question towards the end of chapter 6. And Krishna has already answered the question. So now it's Arjuna's time to speak. You see, with the flow, Krishna has already answered the question and that's it. Now Arjuna will speak. So Arjuna will either ask something or he will comment something. But chapter number 7 begins without Krishna. Without Arjuna asking any question, Krishna is directly speaking without waiting for Arjuna to ask a question on this subject matter, because Krishna, obviously, he knows the importance of this subject matter. So these chapters where Krishna speaks without Arjuna asking a question are even more special. All chapters are very special, but the chapters where Krishna speaks from his heart without Arjuna asking a question, those chapters are even more special. So the middle section begins by Krishna speaking on his own without Arjuna asking any questions. So as we discussed before, Bhagavad Gita is divided into three sections. We have finished the first six sections, which is titled as Karma Yoga, or Krishna talks about how karma leads to bhakti. The middle six sections deal exclusively with bhakti, and the last six sections deal with how jnana leads to bhakti. So the most precious objects are normally kept in the middle, right? If we have a treasure, some jewelry, some precious diamonds, we keep it in a lock, in a cupboard, in a nice box, so that it is covered from all the sides. So therefore, this middle six section, they are so special. That's why it's in the middle of the Bhagavad Gita. That's how special this section is. Now, middle six chapters, the middle of the middle six chapters are Chapter 9 and Chapter 10, which is slicing the Gita into two. So Chapter 9 is titled as the most confidential knowledge. Okay. And then in the beginning of Chapter 10, Krishna says, now in Chapter 9, Krishna has spoken the most confidential knowledge. In Chapter 10, Krishna says, now I will speak to you, which is even more important than what I have spoken of before. So especially in the middle section, the chapters 9 and 10 are even more special. Then in chapter 11, Krishna shows his universal form, his Virat Roop, right? This Virat Roop section also comes in these middle six chapters. And then in chapter 12, the most famous chapter 12, devotees especially like to recite chapter 12. Many people, Indians, they have memorized chapter 12. So chapter 12 also comes in these middle six sections of the Bhagavad Gita. Okay, so much for an introduction on this. Now let's go to our yoga ladder. We have a few sections to finish